Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Marks & Spencer after its first half profit smashed forecasts. The news sent the British retailer's stock soaring. It's currently trading nearly 10% higher. Also in focus, shares of Adidas after it announced that it will cut inventory levels more than expected. Shares of the sportswear giant are trading lower by over 1%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of eBay. The company said it expects holiday sales to come in below expectations. Shares of the e-commerce firm plunged over 7.5% in pre-market trade.
Asian markets ended Wednesday trade mostly lower. This is as investors in the region also stayed cautious ahead of Fed Chief Jerome Powell's speech. Japan's Nikkei 225 shed 0.3%, even as the Reuters Sankan survey showed confidence among large Japanese manufacturers rose in November. Some notable stock movements in the region. The Hong Kong listed shares of Chinese conglomerate Ping An tumbled 5.4%, wiping out almost $2.1 billion in market capitalization. This is on reports Chinese authorities had asked the firm to take a controlling stake in troubled developer Country Garden. Country Garden, meanwhile, surged 12% to a one-month high. Now over to Singapore, major telco Singtel saw its stock plunge 4.8%, its biggest daily loss in 3 months. That's after its unit Optus suffered an outage in Australia, leaving millions without internet and disrupting payment systems and train networks. As for the local bourse, it closed higher ahead of the third quarter GDP report on Thursday, but still on anemic volumes.
If we would look at the value turnover, it's still anemic. So, but if we would look at how the market moves, we have a resistance level and support levels being respected. Evidently, we just reached a 6,000 level in the previous weeks, and we're now on this rebound towards a 6,300 level.
International Monetary Fund upgrades its growth forecast for China this year and the next. The IMF said Tuesday it expects the world's second largest economy to expand by 5.4% this year. That's slightly higher than its earlier forecast of 5%. The IMF said, though, that continued weakness in China's property sector and subdued external demand could restrict its growth to 4.6% in 2024. Meanwhile, global asset managers attending an investment summit in Hong Kong are also bullish on the Chinese economy amid a domestic policy shift.
Domestic investments are the driver of what we see as the long-term opportunities in China. Right now, cyclical challenges, but long-term, all of us, everyone understands that this is a central part of the global economy and global markets.
China and the Chinese economy is such a key part of the global economy. That is not going to end anytime soon. It's a key part of global supply chains. It's a key part of what keeps global capital flowing around the world. And therefore, I think a healthy Chinese economy is extremely important to the health of the global economy, to the growth of the global economy.